Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am going to take a lecture on heat and mass transfer. So in this lecture, I am going to revise all the 5 units in the exam point of view. So you may be preparing for the university examination right now. And the important topics for examination, I am going to discuss here in this lecture. And I will give the resources for the subject heat and mass transfer. Based on my experience, I have uploaded 380 video lectures in YouTube channel in various subjects for your mechanical engineering, heat and mass transfer. Right now, heat and mass transfer, 61 lectures, engineering thermodynamics, 54 lectures, gate question paper, solution for gate question paper, 42 lectures, fluid mechanics and machines, 51 lectures, thermal engineering 1, 38 lectures, thermal engineering 2, 32 lectures, design of transmission system, so in the 6th semester, 47 lectures, operation research, 7 lectures, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, 34 lectures. So presently I am working on operation research and I am uploading the video lectures. So there are total 38 lectures. For the 6th semester, you may refer to the heat and mass transfer and the design of transmission systems. And for heat and mass transfer, so these are all the best books in the world. So heat transfer, a practical approach by Senjal. Fundamentals of Heat and Mass Transfer by Inkropira DeWitt. Heat Transfer, a Basic Approach by Osisik. Heat Transfer by A. B. John. And Heat Transfer by J. P. Holman. So, all these books are very important and they will discuss the practical problem in the Heat and Mass Transfer. And based on my experience in teaching the subject Heat and Mass Transfer for more than 10 times, I have written a book on Heat and Mass Transfer, published by Anuradha Publication, Chennai. If you wish, you can refer to the book. It is available in the market. You can refer to the book and use the book for your preparation. And this book, Heat and Mass Transfer Data Book by C.P. Kodandraman and Subramanian, is mandatory for solving the problem and to collect the property and the equations for solving the problem. If you have a copy of the booklet, it is all right. Or if you want the lecture notes or the soft copy of the Heat and Mass Transfer Data Book, you write to my mail ID or in the comments box of this video, you comment. I will respond to your call. So I will share the link. I have the Telegram channel also. In the Telegram channel, all the subjects, video lectures, lecture notes, 2 mark question and answer, everything is available. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number, or in this video and in the comments box, you can comment, you can give your requirement. I will send the details. And the syllabus of the subject heat and mass transfer, there are 5 units. First unit, conduction heat transfer. Second unit, convection heat transfer. Third unit, heat transfer with the phase change and the heat exchanger. Fourth unit, radiation heat transfer. And fifth unit, mass transfer. So, we will take one by one every unit. And what are all the important topic on the particular unit that you have to focus for examination. The unit 1, conduction. I divide the entire first unit into 7 different topics. Derivation of general heat conduction equation in Cartesian and cylindrical coordinates. This is only a theory question. One-dimensional steady-state heat transfer without heat generation. There are 3 geometries we have to discuss: slab, cylinder, and the sphere. Then one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer with the heat generation. Again, slab, cylinder, and the sphere. And critical radius of insulation. Heat transfer in fins. They will ask only problem. Heat transfer, transient heat transfer. There are 3 topics in the transient heat transfer: lumped parameter method, semi-infinite solid, infinite solid. Again, there are 3 geometries: slab, cylinder, and the sphere. So, excepting the first part all the remaining 6 parts, they will ask only problem in the part B or part C. So there is a possibility of part C questions also from the conduction heat transfer. So in the first one dimensional steady state heat transfer without heat generation, so if they will ask a problem, 70% of the time they will ask a problem on the slab, composite slab, and 30% of the time they will ask a problem on the composite cylinder. So the composite sphere, they do not ask question. Of course, composite sphere is not in our syllabus. So the slab and the cylinder, they are important. And in all the in the table, I have last column, I have shaded with this different colors, green, yellow and red. From exam point of view, the red color, you need not to focus, you need not to study even. The green is very, very important, and yellow is also important. So if you are very good in the green color, so if you are thorough in the green color area, then you can easily attempt a question in the conduction heat transfer. So which is important? Heat transfer in fins, transient heat transfer lumped parameter method. So definitely they will ask a problem. If you are good at the 3 topics, you can easily make an attempt in the conduction heat transfer. Of course, the derivation for heat conduction is the equation, the Cartesian coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system, rarely they are asking. And problem in the critical radius of insulation or heat generation, it is also very rare. I will discuss the 3 topics, the important topics in the heat conduction. So composite slab. So this is again the information available in your heat and mass transfer data book. So there are 3 layer of slab. 3 layers are L1, L2, L3 of thickness, thermal conductivity K1, K2, K3, and left side there is a fluid of temperature TA with the heat transfer coefficient HA. Right side there is a fluid of temperature TB and the heat transfer coefficient HB. Now there are 5 resistances. So 3 resistances offered by the slab and 1 resistance by the fluid on the left side, another resistance by the fluid on the right side. All the resistances are given here. So the equation very much available in your data book. So R equal to 1 by A. A is area normal to heat transfer. So the area is, this is the area normal to, so this is the direction, horizontal x direction is the direction of heat transfer, and area normal to heat transfer is the rectangular area. Normally in the problem you will be given the area, or you have to assume unit area. So the resistance are 1 by HA plus L1 by K1 plus L2 by K2 plus L3 by K3 plus 1 by HB. Now after calculating the resistance, you can calculate the heat transfer. Heat transfer equal to TA minus TB divided by sum of all the resistances. Then intermediate temperature, suppose you have to calculate the intermediate temperature T1, T2, T3 and T4, then you have to use this equation. Again the heat transfer Q equal to TA minus T1 divided by RA. So that is the heat transfer in the first liquid phase, temperature difference between the fluid and the surface, inner surface, divided by the corresponding resistance. For the slab, first slab T1 minus T2 divided by R1, second slab T2 minus T3 divided by R2, third slab T3 minus T4 divided by R3, and the fourth, the fluid on the right side, T4 minus TB divided by RB. So normally you will be given any of the 2 temperatures, or you will be given the extreme temperatures. So you have to calculate the intermediate temperature and the rate of heat transfer. Similarly, composite cylinder. So for the composite cylinder, again there are 3 layers of cylinder, and you have the length L, and you have R1, R2, R3, R4, and you have the fluid inside which is flowing with the temperature TA and the heat transfer coefficient HA, and you have the fluid on the outside with the temperature TB and the heat transfer coefficient HB. Now the resistance 1 by 2 pi L into, for the fluid, 1 by HA into R1 plus 1 by K1 logarithmic of R2 by R1 plus 1 by K2 logarithmic of R3 by R2 plus 1 by K3 logarithmic of R4 by R3 plus 1 by HB R4. This is the total resistance, and you have to calculate the heat transfer and the intermediate temperature using the previous equation. So the same equations you can use to calculate the heat transfer and the intermediate temperature. So this is about the composite slab and the composite cylinder. So you take up the equation and solve the problem. So you can refer to my video lecture or refer to my notes. So you may find the solved problem. You can read it, understand, and you solve a problem on your own. Then the heat transfer in the extended surface or the fin. There are three different types of fins normally required for solving in the problem in the heated mass transfer. One is long fin, short fin end insulated, short fin end not insulated. So here what is important? Temperature distribution and the heat transfer by the fin. So temperature distribution is TB minus T infinity divided by TB minus T infinity. The TB is the base temperature, T infinity is the fluid temperature, and T is the temperature at any given position x. So x is from x equal to 0 at the base, and it is a length x equal to L at the tip of the fin. So for long fin, temperature distribution equal to U to the power of minus mx. So m equal to square root of hb by ka. So that hb by ka is also available, m value is also available in the data book in the next page. And heat transfer for a long fin, TB minus T infinity into hb ka to the power 0.5. So normally in the classroom you would have studied square root of hb ka. So this is the heat transfer. Similarly for short fin end insulated, temperature distribution is cos h m l minus x divided by cos h m l. So cos h hyperbolic cos. So in the calculator you have to press the hyperbolic cos. So m into l minus x divided by cos h m l. And the heat transfer, look at the equation, the different two different equation. The previous two terms are very much available. Square root of hp ka into tb minus t infinity. What is the additional term? Tan h m l. Then efficiency of this fin equal to tan h m l by m l. Then short fin end not insulated. So here temperature distribution is cos h m l minus x into h by m k. So not h into l. Heat transfer coefficient at the length l. So h suffix l. So better you read h by m k into sin h m l minus x divided by cos h m l. H by m k sin h m l. So similarly heat transfer, the first term, the two terms are available, T B minus T infinity and the square root of h p k is available. And the second, third term is tan h m l plus h by m k divided by 1 plus h by m k tan h m l. So this is the fin. And here, unless the fin is specified, long fin, short fin, end insulated, if it is not specified, we have to assume, you have to take that short fin, end not insulated. So this is, if you are able to solve problem using the equations given here, and you can easily make an attempt on the problem in the fins. And in the transient heat transfer problem, lumped parameter method is very important. So in the lumped parameter method, what is the assumption? What is the description for lumped parameter? The body with the high thermal conductivity suddenly exposed to the convective atmosphere. So lumped parameter method, in the lumped parameter method, we assume that thermal conductivity of material is very, very high. Normally, the highest thermal conductivity is for copper 386. We have to assume, so even for the lumped parameter method, we assume that thermal conductivity tends to infinity. So there is no such a material, but you can justify when the parameter HL by KS is less than 0.1. When HL by KS is less than 0.1, we can apply the lumped parameter method, and HL by KS is called as Biot number. So look at here, we have the Biot number. Biot number is the non-dimensional number, which is HL by KS. H is the heat transfer coefficient, L is the characteristic length. Look at here, characteristic length equal to V by AS. So V is the volume, AS is the surface area. So using the first step, you have to calculate the Biot number. So if the Biot number is less than 0.1, we have to apply the lumped parameter method. If the Biot number is greater than 0.1, then you have to solve the problem by Heisler and Grober chart. So that is infinite solid. We have to assume that the solid is infinite, and you have to solve the problem with Geissler and the Grober chart. So here again, lumped parameter method. So we have to find the temperature distribution, T minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity equal to, TO is the initial temperature, T infinity is the fluid temperature, T is the temperature for any given time. So it is exponential of minus HAS divided by CV rho into T. So T is the time, H is the heat transfer coefficient, AS is the surface area, C is the specific heat of the material, V is the volume of the solid, and rho is the density of the material. So using this equation, you can calculate the temperature. So you will be given time, you have to calculate the temperature, or you will be given temperature, you have to find out the time. So you can refer the problem, you can solve the problem using the equation. And the heat transfer, instantaneous heat transfer or total heat transfer. Instantaneous heat transfer Q equal to HAIS into T minus T infinity, and total heat flow equal to rho CV into T minus TU. So these are all the parameters that you have to calculate. And here one parameter is there, time constant. And using the lumped parameter method, the thermocouple design, the diameter of the end of the thermocouple is fixed by the lumped parameter method. So the time constant should be minimum. So when the time constant is minimum, then the response of the thermocouple will be quick. So the for minimum time constant, we have to design the thermocouple. So this is the lumped parameter method. And the semi-infinite solid. So here there is only one type, there are three types of problems in the semi-infinite solid. The first type is surface temperature suddenly changed and maintained constant. Second type is constant surface heat flux. Third type is convection surface. So this is the semi-infinite solid. The example for the semi-infinite solid is the earth surface. So earth surface, we have a flat surface and you have infinite length in the remaining directions. So you, in all the other directions, we have the infinite length. Such a solid is called as semi-infinite solid. The earth surface is the best example for semi-infinite solid. So normally in the transportation of liquid fuel, gaseous fuel in the form of liquid or gas, we transport underground pipe, through the underground pipe. So at what height we have to, at what depth we have to bury the pipeline. So that is decided by the calculation here. So because the temperature, when you go down the earth surface, the temperature increases. So the temperature should not affect the, evaporate the fuel in the pipeline. So we have to carefully design the location where the temperature is not disturbing the gas flow or the liquid fuel flow. So that is based on the first type. The second two types are not important from exam point of view. So here again, the equations are cumbersome and you have to refer the chart to solve the problem. So here we have straight away equations available and you can solve the problem. So for this type of problem, we have the temperature distribution, instantaneous heat flow and overall heat flow. So QO is the heat flux at the surface, QX is the heat flux at the location and QT is the total heat flow. So here Tx minus To divided by Ti minus To equal to error function of x divided by 2 into square root of alpha t. So To is the surface temperature, Tx is the temperature at any location and Ti is the initial temperature. Error function of, this is error function of x divided by 2 into square root of alpha t. T is the time, alpha is the thermal diffusivity. And the error function value is available on the next page. So you look at the here, error function, refer the table on the next page. So next page, we have to take the error function value. Then you can calculate all the other parameters referring to the equation. So these are all the important for conduction heat transfer problems, for solving problem in the conduction heat transfer. And the important theory question so far. So far asked in the university examination, derive the general heat conduction equation in the Cartesian coordinate, May 2010. Derive the heat conduction equation in the cylindrical coordinate using an elemental volume for stationary isotropic fluid. It is on November 2007. And explain briefly the concept of critical thickness of insulation and state any two applications of the same. What is the application of critical thickness of insulation? One application what we know, what we use is the insulated electrical wires. Insulating electrical wire is one application. Another application is insulating the steam pipe. So in the steam power plant, the steam is taken from one place to another place, particularly from boiler to the turbine through the pipe. So in this case, the pipes are insulated. So pipes are insulated. So that is the using the critical thickness. So that is one application. Another application is the refrigerator, air conditioner. In the air conditioner, we have the indoor unit and the outdoor unit. So the outdoor unit compressor you have outside. So from the compressor, the gas refrigerant is taken to the indoor unit through a copper tube. The copper tube is insulated. So that is also based on the critical thickness of insulation. So these are all the three applications of critical insulation of the material against the conduction heat transfer. And how to solve the problem here? Write down the given data with appropriate unit, draw the network diagram and refer the HMT data book for equations or values. So normally in the all the types of heat transfer, the equations are available in the heat and mass transfer data book. You have to locate it appropriate pages and you have to take the equation and calculate the unknown. So here the unknowns are rate of heat transfer and the interface temperature, or temperature or rate of heat transfer. So these are all the, this is how we have to solve the problem in the conduction heat transfer. So that's all about the first unit. Now I take the second unit, convection heat transfer. So in the convection heat transfer, I divide the entire syllabus into three topics: forced convection external flow, so flow over plate, flow over cylinder and flow over sphere, and forced convection internal flow, flow through the pipeline, and the free convection. So in all the three cases, 99% they ask only problem in the university examination in the part B. And here, if you are very good at the forced convection external flow, plate, cylinder and the sphere, flow over plate, flow over cylinder or flow over sphere, again you should be good at plate, flow over the plate. Majority of the time they ask a problem on flow over plate. Very rarely they ask a problem on flow over cylinder or the sphere. And free convection, again free convection over the plate or the cylinder, horizontal cylinder. And if you are good at the 1 and 3 to solve a problem, you can easily make an attempt in the convection heat transfer. So here there is only one theory questions applied so far. So explain the thermal and the velocity boundary layer for the flow over horizontal plate. So this is the only theory questions. Very rarely they ask theory questions here. And for convection heat transfer, the non-dimensional numbers are very important. So based on the non-dimensional numbers only, we are going to calculate the parameter. Again, here the parameter that we have to calculate is the heat transfer coefficient and the rate of heat transfer. So for forced convection, the three non-dimensional numbers, Reynolds number, Prandtl number and Nusselt number. Again, the definitions, equations are available in the heat and mass transfer data book. Reynolds number, inertia force by viscous force. So U infinity or simply U, velocity into length divided by nu. Nu is the kinematic viscosity. For cylindrical system, velocity into diameter divided by the kinematic viscosity. And what is the significance of Reynolds number? Reynolds number determines whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Depending on the critical value of Reynolds number, the flow may be laminar flow or the turbulent flow. And the Prandtl number, it is defined like this. Diffusivity of momentum divided by diffusivity of heat. Nu by alpha. Nu is the kinematic viscosity, alpha is the thermal diffusivity. And Nusselt number. Nusselt number is temperature gradient by conduction divided by temperature gradient by convection. So in the, this may be HL by K or HD by K for cylindrical system. And the non-dimensional number for free convection, natural convection or the free convection, Grassof number. So Grassof number is the ratio of buoyancy force to the viscous force. So GR equal to G beta into TW minus T infinity L to the power 3 divided by nu square. Where beta is the coefficient of volume expansion, which is 1 by Tf. Tf is the flume temperature. L is the characteristic length. So here, what is the significance of this Grassof number? For laminar flow, GRPR is less than 10 power 9. The product of Grassof number and the Prandtl number is less than 10 power 9. For turbulent flow, GRPR is greater than 10 power 9. And the product of GRPR, Grassof number and the Prandtl number is called as Rayleigh number, RA. RA is the Rayleigh number. Then how to solve the problem here in the convection heat transfer. So this flow chart will help you to solve the problem in the convection heat transfer. So I said there are three types: forced convection external flow, forced convection internal flow and free convection. For forced convection external flow, first you have to calculate Reynolds number. When the Reynolds number is less than 10 power 5 into 10 power 5, that is 5 lakh, the flow is laminar. When the Reynolds number is greater than 5 lakh, 5 into 10 power 5, the flow is turbulent. So whether the flow is laminar or turbulent, you have to take the Nusselt equation from the heat and mass transfer data book. So depending on the type of flow, laminar flow or turbulent flow, depending on the geometry, whether the flow over plate, flow over cylinder or flow over sphere, you have to refer to the data book, take the Nusselt equation, which is a function of Reynolds number and Prandtl number. Then you have to calculate the Nusselt number. So from the Nusselt number, you have to calculate the heat transfer coefficient. Then you have to calculate the rate of heat transfer. So you have to calculate the Reynolds number, then you have to take the Nusselt equation, calculate the Nusselt number, calculate the heat transfer coefficient and calculate the rate of heat transfer. In the case of forced convection internal flow, again you have to calculate the Reynolds number. When the Reynolds number is less than 2300, the flow is laminar. When the Reynolds number is greater than 2300, the flow is turbulent. Then again, based on the type of flow And normally flow, internal flow, we will be given only pipe, circular pipe. We have to take the Nusselt number equal to a function of Reynolds number to Prandtl. You have to take the Nusselt equation, again calculate the Nusselt number, calculate the heat transfer coefficient and calculate the rate of heat transfer. If it is free convection, you have to calculate GR, PR. So GR Grashof number you have to calculate, PR value you have to multiply by GR, PR. When the GR, PR is less than 10 power 9, the flow is laminar. When the GR, PR is greater than 10 power 9, the flow is turbulent. And again, based on the type of flow and type of the geometry, you have to take the Nusselt number equal to a function of GR, PR, Grashof number and the Prandtl number. Then you calculate the Nusselt number, calculate the rate of heat transfer coefficient and calculate the rate of heat transfer. So this is the table, this is the flow chart which will help you to solve the problem in the convection heat transfer. And how to solve the problem? Write down the given data with appropriate unit. Take the properties of the fluid at the film temperature if it is not given in the problem. So majority of the time, you have to take the property from the film temperature. Again, the fluid may be air or the water. Maximum, majority of the cases, it may be air or water. So you take the properties of water and the air from the data book and draw the diagram with the given data. So diagrammatic representation of the problem is very important, and better draw the diagram, always draw the diagram with a pencil. Calculate the Reynolds number or Rayleigh number and check the flow, whether the laminar flow or turbulent flow. Refer Heaton Marstrand's data book for the Nusselt equation. You take the Nusselt equation, calculate the Nusselt number and the heat transfer coefficient and calculate the rate of heat transfer. So this is the methodology to solve the problem in the convection heat transfer. Then the third unit, heat transfer with a phase change and the heat exchanger. So here I have three topics again, heat transfer with the phase change, conduction, boiling and the heat exchanger. There are two methods in solving problem in the heat exchanger, LMTD method and effectiveness NTU method. So you can boiling, you can skip because 99% they ask only theory question from the boiling heat transfer. So they may ask a problem in the condensation or any one of the heat exchanger design. So normally there is a possibility of part C question from the heat exchanger. So part C question, majority of the time they ask a problem from the heat exchanger design. And here the theory question so far, explain with a neat sketch and labeled sketch, explain the various regimes of boiling heat transfer. So this is only one theory question in the boiling heat transfer. Explain how the heat exchanger are classified, sketch the temperature variation, parallel flow, counter flow heat exchanger, compare LMTD NTU method in heat exchanger. These are all the few questions, theory questions, important theory questions in the third unit. And here boiling heat transfer. So this is the boiling curve. This is the boiling curve. So the boiling curve, there are four regimes. There are four regions. First regime, natural convection boiling regime. Second regime, nucleate boiling regime. Third regime, transition boiling regime. And fourth regime, film boiling regime. So here x-axis is delta T, excess temperature. Y-axis, heat flux for the boiling in watts per meter square. So when the temperature, excess temperature increases, excess temperature equal to TS minus heat saturation. T saturation is the saturation temperature of the fluid. TS is the surface temperature of the heating surface. So when the temperature increases, the heat flux is increasing. So from the initial condition to the A. Initial condition to the A, it is called as natural convection boiling. Normally, to understand the curve, we have to heat water. In a open vessel, you take a water in the open vessel and heat the water. So what do you observe? For a certain time, there is nothing you observe, just water is getting heated up. So that is called as natural convection boiling. After some time, what you may find at the bottom surface of the vessel, you may find small bubbles at the bottom at different places. The bubble, small size of the bubble, then the bubble size will grow and the bubble will be removed from the surface, moving in the upward direction. Before it reaches the surface, the bubble collapses. Then after some time, the number of bubbles are increasing. The bubbles are vigorously forming on the bottom surface and bubbles are moving from the bottom surface and reaches the top surface. So the bubble reaching the top surface, bubble formation, bubble reaching the top surface, that is called as nucleate boiling region. So in the natural convection boiling region, The earlier chapter we studied the natural convection heat transfer. The equations applicable, available in the natural convection is applicable, but we up to A. Up to A. A to B, the nucleate boiling is divided again into two parts, A to B and B to C. So A to B is the bubble collapses within the liquid, and B to C, bubble raised to the free surface of the liquid. So here A to C, we have the equations to calculate the heat transfer, heat flux. This is the equations available. So Q by A, heat flux, which is mu L H of G, G into rho L minus rho V by sigma to the power 0.5 into C L delta T divided by CSF H of G Prandtl number to the power n to the power 3. All the definitions are available here. And critical heat flux are the maximum heat flux. So this second equation is applicable here to the point C. This is the maximum or the critical heat flux. So this is the nucleate boiling. So at this point C, there will be vigorous formation of bubbles. That is what nucleate boiling. After some time, what will happen? The bubble at the bottom surface, they will form a major, it will cover the surface. It will cover the bottom surface. When it covers the bottom surface, the amount of heat transfer decreases. That is called as transition boiling. So there will be a vapor layer available at the bottom of the vessel. So the vapor layer will reduce the heat transfer from the surface to the liquid. So that is why the heat transfer heat flux is decreasing up to D. So in the transition boiling, the heat flux is decreasing up to point D. Then from D to E, that is the film boiling. Again, the heat flux is increasing. So this is because of radiation. So the surface starts to radiate heat. So the surface, there will be more heat transfer between the fluid and the surface. So here, natural convection boiling, nucleate boiling, transition boiling and the film boiling. These are all the four regions. For if at all they ask a theory questions, you have to draw the diagram and you have to explain each region. So natural convection region, nucleate boiling region, transition boiling region and film boiling region. What is happening and what are all the equations available for calculating the heat flux in the nucleate boiling, that you have to explain. That is what the theory question. Rarely they ask a problem in the boiling heat transfer. And the condensation, so condensation is perfectly opposite. So the boiling is converting liquid into vapor, condensation is converting vapor into liquid. So in the condensation heat transfer, we have three important equations. There are only three equations available for solving the problem. One is vertical surface, horizontal tube and banks of end tubes. For vertical surface, maybe flow over vertical cylinder or vertical rectangular surface. So for that, heat transfer coefficient equal to 0.943 K to the power 3 rho square G into H of G divided by mu L into Tv minus Ts to the power 0.25. So K is thermal conductivity, rho is the density, G is the acceleration due to gravity, H of G is the latent heat of vaporization, mu L is the absolute viscosity of the liquid, L is the length, vertical length, Tv is the vapor temperature, Ts is the surface temperature. So you have to calculate the heat transfer coefficient and then the heat transfer. So if they ask the thermal, the boundary layer thickness, that you have to use the equation delta x. Delta x is the boundary layer thickness. And if it is a horizontal tube, then h equal to 0.728 into again the same equation. Here L is replaced by D. All the other terms are very much similar. L is replaced by D. Suppose you have horizontal n tubes, n is the number of rows. So here, look at the second equation, third equation, very much identical. Denominator is multiplied by n. So these three, using these three equations, you have to solve the problem in the condensation heat transfer. And these are all the various terms connected with the equation. N, capital N, is the number of horizontal rows placed one over the other, irrespective of number of tubes in the horizontal row. So horizontal number of rows of the horizontal tube, that is what the N. Then, how to solve the problem? Write down the given data with the appropriate unit. Draw the diagram with the given data. Refer heat and mass transfer data book for equations. Calculate the heat transfer coefficient for condensation, heat flux for boiling. These are all the two set of equations available. You have to take, calculate the rate of heat transfer, calculate the rate of condensation or evaporation. Rate of evaporation you have to calculate or rate of condensation you have to calculate. So next one is heat exchanger. So here we have one method is LMTD method. So LMTD method is logarithmic, mean, temperature difference method. So here, how to solve the problem? Write down the given data with the appropriate unit. Draw the diagram with the given data. So for parallel flow, there are different types of heat exchanger, as you know, parallel flow heat exchanger, counter flow heat exchanger, cross flow heat exchanger. So you have to draw the temperature distribution, a simple line diagram, diagram of the heat exchanger. Then calculate the LMTD. So for calculating LMTD, you have to take the equation from the heat and mass transfer data book. So LMTD equation is also available in the heat and mass transfer data book. Calculate the correction factor. So this is another factor for heat exchanger design, LMTD method. So you have to take the correction factor from the chart available in the heat and mass transfer data book. Calculate the rate of heat transfer and calculate the area of the heat exchanger. So these are all the unknown. So sometimes you will be given area, you have to calculate the rate of heat transfer, or you will be given rate of heat exchanger, rate of heat transfer, you have to calculate the area of the heat exchanger. Then the heat exchanger, for heat exchanger, this is the page in the heat and mass transfer data book for both the LMTD and the effectiveness NTE method. For LMTD method, so the first look at the equation, Q heat transfer Q equal to UA into delta T LM. Delta T LM is the logarithmic mean temperature difference. A is the heat transfer area, U is the overall heat transfer coefficient. So you will be given overall heat transfer coefficient, either you have to calculate A or delta Q. So Q or A, you will be given Q, you have to calculate the area, and if you are given A, you have to calculate the heat transfer. So for parallel flow, delta T LM, so you have the equation for parallel flow heat exchanger, delta T LM equal to capital T1 minus small t1 minus capital T2 minus small t2 divided by logarithmic of capital T1 minus small t1 divided by capital T2 minus small t2. So here capital T stands for hot fluid, 1 stands for inlet, 2 stands for outlet. Small t stands for cold fluid, 1 stands for inlet and 2 stands for outlet. So for example, capital T1, hot fluid inlet temperature. Small T2, cold fluid outlet temperature. So this is for the parallel flow heat exchanger. For counter flow heat exchanger, T1 small capital T1 minus small T2 minus capital T2 minus small T1 divided by the logarithmic of capital T1 minus small T2 divided by capital T2 minus small T1. So this is the parallel counter flow heat exchanger. If it is simple parallel flow heat exchanger, simple counter flow heat exchanger, you can take the equation, calculate the LMTD and substitute here, you can calculate the heat transfer or area. Other than simple parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger, we have to use this equation. So for multi-pass or the cross flow heat exchanger, you have to take Q equal to F into U into A into delta T LM. So here delta T LM star. So you have to here substitute the LMTD value for counter flow configuration. And F is the correction factor. The correction factor you have to take from the chart for different types of multi-pass or cross-flow heat exchanger. The charts are available in the heat and mass transfer data book. From the chart, you have to take the F value, correction factor. So this is the LMTD method. And the effectiveness NTU method, NTU stands for number of transfer unit, number of transfer unit. So in the NTU method, so you remember this equation, Q equal to epsilon into C minimum into T1 minus T1, capital T1 minus small t1. Hot fluid inlet temperature, cold fluid inlet temperature, C minimum is the minimum heat capacity and epsilon is the effectiveness. So effectiveness equal to here, you have to refer to the effectiveness. Effectiveness equal to MHCH divided by C minimum into T1 minus T2 divided by T1 minus capital T1 minus small t1, and referring to this equation, you can calculate the effectiveness value. And in the NT, what is the advantage of NT method? So in the LMTD method, you require minimum 3 temperatures to calculate the LMTD. So when you are given, all the 4 temperatures are required. So when you are given 3 temperatures, you can calculate the 4th temperature. But in few problems, sometimes the 4 temperatures may not be available. You will be given only 2 temperatures, inlet temperature of the 2 fluids. In that case, you have to use only the effectiveness NT method. So again in the problem, if it is mentioned that solve the problem by LMTD method, solve the problem by NTU method, then you have to use the specific method. If it is not mentioned, it is your choice. So you can use either LMTD method or effectiveness NTU method provided based on the data given. If you are given only 2 temperature, you have to necessarily take the effectiveness NTU method, right? So remember that. So depending on the availability of data, it is your choice either to use the LMTD method or effectiveness NTU method. In the effectiveness NTU method, there are 2 types of problem. One is rating problem, another one is sizing problem. So what is rating problem, what is sizing problem, how to solve the problem in the rating type or the sizing type. So this is the rating problem. What is rating problem? You have to calculate the outlet temperature of the two fluid, THO and TCO. The outlet temperature of two fluid, you will be given rest of the values. So what is the procedure to solve the problem in the rating problem, effectiveness entry method? Calculate the heat capacity of the cold fluid. So CC, capital CC equal to MC into CPC. So MC is the mass of the cold fluid, CPC is the specific heat of the cold fluid. Calculate the heat capacity of the hot fluid, CH equal to MH into CPH. Then you calculate the ratio, C equal to C minimum by C maximum, and you calculate the NTU, number of transfer unit, which is UA by C minimum. So now we have the two values, C value and NTU value. So based on the C and the NTU value, you have to refer to the chart. So using the chart, you have to find out the effectiveness. The chart is for different types of heat exchanger. For different types of heat exchanger, we have the effectiveness value. So based on the C value and the NTU value, calculate the effectiveness. Once you have the effectiveness, then calculate the heat transfer, actual heat transfer. So Q equal to epsilon C minimum into THI minus TCI. So or you refer to the data book and take the equation. Then from that you calculate the unknown temperature. So THO equal to THI minus Q by CH, or TCO equal to TCI plus Q by CC. So using the value, you can calculate the outlet temperature of the hot fluid and outlet temperature of the cold fluid. So this is the rating problem. For sizing problem, you will be given the temperature, you have to calculate the area. So size, the area of the heat exchanger, you have to calculate. Again, the first two steps are very much equal. You have to calculate the CH and CC, calculate the C value in the ratio of C minimum by C maximum, and calculate the effectiveness of the heat exchanger. So in the data book, the equation for effectiveness is available. You calculate the effectiveness. Now, referring to the data book, using the C value and the effectiveness value, you have to take the NTU value from the chart. So in the earlier type of problem, we have taken effectiveness from the chart, and here you know the effectiveness, you have to take the NTU from the chart. Once you know the NTU, area equal to NTU into C minimum by U. So area equal to NTU, number of transfer unit into C minimum by U. So that is the sizing problem. So in heat exchanger, LMTD method, rating problem, sizing problem. So there are three types of problem that you have to solve. Right, so you solve the problem. Refer to the I request you to listen to the visit to the Telegram channel and download the information, or you subscribe the YouTube channel and listen to the video lectures of problem solving in the heat exchanger. And fourth unit, radiation heat transfer. So in the radiation heat transfer, again I divide the entire chapter into five chapters, the entire unit into five chapters, and here fourth chapter and the fifth chapter we can skip. Radiation between three surface enclosure and gas radiation, that you can skip for examination point of view, and you should be thorough on the remaining three topics. And the majority of the time you may expect a problem on the radiation shield. So radiation between two surfaces and the radiation shield, or they will ask a problem on the radiation shape factor calculation or basic radiation calculation. In the basic radiation theory, you will be given, you have to define the radiation properties, Wien's displacement law, Stefan Boltzmann law and Kirchhoff's law. Sometimes they may ask you theory questions on the Kirchhoff's law. State and prove the Kirchhoff's law. So the first part, it is only theory question. Rarely they ask a problem. Second part, there will be a problem. And the third, there is definitely a problem. You should be thorough on the first three topics. And the fourth topic and fifth topic, you can skip from the examination point of view. And this is the, I explain you the radiation shield. So this is one surface, surface 1, with the area A1, temperature T1, emissivity epsilon 1. There is another surface, surface 2, area A2, temperature T2, emissivity epsilon 2. So these two surfaces, they are exchanging heat by radiation. We want to reduce the radiation heat transfer. So for example, the best example for radiation shield is your sunglass. So we wear the sunglass during the summer time. So the sunglass will reduce the heat transfer between the sun, solar system and our eyes. The amount of heat falling on our eyes is reduced by the radiation shield, by the sunglass. So the sunglass acting as a radiation shield. So the radiation shield, for the radiation shield, the temperature is T3, A3, area is A3, and emissivity is epsilon 31 and epsilon 32. And when you consider the system, there are 6 resistances. So here we can classify the resistance into 2 types. One is surface resistance. 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 epsilon 1 is the surface resistance. 1 minus epsilon 31 divided by A3 epsilon 31 is also surface resistance. 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 epsilon 2 is the surface resistance. And here shape factor resistance, 1 by A1 F13 is a shape factor resistance. 1 by A2 F23 is also a shape factor resistance. So the heat transfer between the two surfaces, the amount of heat transfer between the two surfaces is the calculator like this. Q net equal to sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by all the resistances. Now, we have to simplify. So what is the assumption for simplification? We assume the area are equal. A1 equal to A2 equal to A3 equal to A. We assume long parallel plates. When you assume long parallel plates, the shape factor is F1, F13 equal to 1, F31 equal to 1, F23 equal to 1, F32 equal to 1. Now, implementing these two conditions here, we can simplify the equation. The simplified equation is sigma A into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1 plus 1 by epsilon 31 plus 1 by epsilon 32 minus 1. And this is the heat transfer, net heat transfer with radiation shield. When there is no radiation shield, the second part of the denominator is removed. This becomes zero. When there is no radiation shield, the second part will be removed. So when you add something in the denominator, the amount of heat transfer will decrease. So when you insert a radiation shield, the amount of heat transfer will decrease. So here we have to calculate the heat transfer without radiation shield and heat transfer with radiation shield. And the percentage of reduction in the heat transfer. That is the question. So this again, equation we have to be very familiar. So we have to understand and remember this equation so that you can comfortably solve your problem in the radiation shield. And how to solve the problem here? Write down the given data with appropriate unit. Draw the network diagram for the radiation problem. Right? Refer the heat and mass transfer table for properties or equations. Radiation heat transfer also. The equations, various equations, Kirchhoff's law, Wien's displacement law, Stefan Boltzmann law, all the equations are available. Shape factor values, shape factor equations are also available in the data book. Then you have to refer and calculate the unknown, the heat transfer or the sometimes the application problem also will be asked. So you have to calculate the unknown. And the unit number 5, mass transfer. So here I divide the entire unit into 4 different topics. The basic definition, diffusion velocity, fixed law of diffusion, diffusion in gases. So this is only theory part. Isothermal evaporation of water, there is only one equation, Stefan equation. So using that equation you have to solve the problem. Convection mass transfer. So like convection heat transfer, we have convection mass transfer. So here again you have problem. An analogy between momentum, heat and mass transfer, it is only theory. So, if you are good at the 2 area where there is a problem, right, problem solving, you can comfortably make an attempt in the mass transfer. So, isothermal evaporation of water, there is only one equation available. So, Stefan equation, it is available in all the textbook and you can copy the equation, you can refer to the notes, you can download my notes from the Telegram channel, you can use the equation and solve the problem. And the convection mass transfer, like convection heat transfer, here again we have to calculate various non-dimensional numbers and solve the problem. Here we have to calculate the convection mass transfer coefficient. So in the convection heat transfer, we have to calculate convection heat transfer coefficient and here we have to calculate convection mass transfer coefficient. An analogy between momentum, heat and mass transfer is a theory question. Very rarely they ask the coefficient. So the non-dimensional numbers in the mass transfer, Sherwood number. Again, the definitions are available in the heat and mass transfer data book. Sherwood number. Concentration gradient at the boundary by diffusion divided by concentration gradient at the boundary by convection. SH equal to KL by D or KD by capital D. So, K is the mass transfer coefficient. L is the length. Capital D is the diffusion coefficient. And here K is the mass transfer coefficient. Small d is the diameter of the pipe. And the capital D is the diffusion coefficient. And Skimmerit number. Molecular diffusivity of momentum divided by molecular diffusivity of mass. So this is nu by d. Nu is the kinematic viscosity and d is the diffusion coefficient. And Lewis number. So Lewis number equal to heat diffusivity divided by mass diffusivity, alpha by D. Alpha is the thermal diffusivity and D is the diffusion coefficient. So these are all the three non-dimensional numbers in the mass transfer calculation, convective mass transfer calculation. And here, these are all the theory questions, possible theory questions. Very rarely they ask a theory question here. Explain fixed and first and second law of diffusion. And explain the phenomenon of equimolar counter diffusion. Derive an expression for equimolar counter diffusion between the two gases or liquid. For the derivation, you can refer to the textbook. My textbook is very, very well explained. The concept is very well, derivation is very well explained. So, explain briefly the similarities between momentum, heat and mass transfer. So, here we have to compare momentum, heat transfer, that is using the Navier-Stokes equation, you have to take the momentum transfer and the heat transfer energy equation and mass transfer concentration equation. So, using that, the theory questions here, it is a one page explanation available in all the textbook. You can refer to the textbook or the notes. And how to solve the problem here? Write down the given data with appropriate unit. Draw the diagram with the given data. Refer HMT data book for equation, particularly convection heat transfer or isothermal evaporation of water. The equations are very much available. Refer to the heat and mass transfer data book. You take the properties from the data book and calculate the unknown. So, here again, in the mass transfer calculation, you have to first calculate the Reynolds number. Check the flow, whether the flow is laminar or turbulent, then you calculate the Sherwood number. So, here the Sherwood number is a function of, Reynolds number and the skim rate number. So, here you have to remember Sherwood number, from the Sherwood number only you have to calculate the K value. So, Sherwood number is a function of Reynolds number and the skim rate number. So, the Reynolds number again you have to calculate here. First you have to calculate the Reynolds number, check the flow, whether the flow is laminar flow or the turbulent flow, then you have to take the Sherwood number equation. Calculate the Sherwood number and calculate the mass transfer coefficient. Okay, so what I have for the subject? I have the lecture notes in the form of PPT. I have 61 video lectures and I have short questions with answers. Everything is available in the Telegram channel. So, the YouTube video lectures are available in the YouTube channel. The link for the video lecture and lecture notes for PPT and PDF format of lecture notes and the short questions, the answer, everything is available in the Telegram channel. You join in the Telegram channel, download the notes and use for your examination. That is what my request. So, these are all the books I have published so far in the mechanical engineering. So, here the heat and mass transfer data book is available. This is published by Anuradha Publications, Chennai. You can contact the publisher or contact the nearest bookstore and you can get the book. And you can subscribe my YouTube channel and refer to the, for all the subjects, for the 7 subjects I have uploaded the video lectures in the YouTube channel. You can subscribe the YouTube channel, use the videos for your better preparation. And if you have any questions, and you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number or in the video. At the video, there is one comment column. You can click the comment and you can type your questions. I will immediately answer to your questions. So, thank you for watching. You follow the instructions. Prepare well for the examination and you appear well and make a pass, comfortable pass in the subject. So, wish you all the best.